Hey bro, what's up?
Not much. What about you?
Oh, I'm on my way to the Christmas program. You want to come along? The church is right over there. It'll be great. You'll like it.
It's kind of busy. And if you ask me, it sounds kind of boring. I've heard of the Christmas story before. Mary, Joseph, the baby, shepherds, angels, and wise men. It's kind of like watching an old replay. And what does that have to do with our lives today? I mean, all that stuff happened more than 2,000 years ago. Things change.
You might be surprised. In the Bible, there's a verse that it says that Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He never changes. I think you just might learn a thing or two from that story.
Come on, I hear the music coming from the church. Let's go to the program, and when it's over, we can go to DQ.
Okay, but since I have boring ass TV replay, you're buying the ice cream. I like caramel.
Don't worry. Come on, let's go.
Sing together.
Luke 2:14. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. Everyone went to their own town to register.
So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee, Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them.
And there are shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. And the angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them,
"Do not be afraid. I bring you good news to cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You'll find a baby wrapped in cloths lying in a manger."
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest. Peace to his people on the earth."
Jesus Christ is born. The
2:15-16. When the angel left them and gone to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurry up and found Mary, Joseph, and the baby, who was lying in the manger.
Now tell me what the shepherds have to do with 2022. I know there are still people who raise sheep, but they don't dress like that, run around with those big sticks.
True, we don't have shepherds like that. But herding sheep was a very popular job back then. Today we have other jobs we do. Here are some modern day shepherds.
People have jobs that they do each day. They all have jobs just like the shepherds had sheep. But the sheep in those jobs don't have to be the most important things in their lives. Jesus wants to be number one.
Children, go where I send you. How shall I send you? I'm gonna send you one by one. One for the little bitty baby born, born, born in Bethlehem.
Even though they all have work to do,
Jesus still comes first for them. If God gives them a job, they may need to leave their tractors and things to serve Him, just like the shepherds left the sheep.
See, it's still the same.
I think I'm starting to understand better. What is it? I think there's more.
Matthew 2:1-11. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him."
When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where was the Messiah to be born. "In Bethlehem and Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written, 'But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the ruler of Judah, for out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel.'"
Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time that the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for a child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so I too may go and worship him."
After they have heard the king, they went down the way, and the star they have seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. "I'm coming to the house." They saw the child with the mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
"I'm sure I already know the answer to this question, but here it goes. Are there still wise men today?"
"Yes, in a way. There are still many gifts we can bring to Jesus, just like those kings from the east."
"I'm looking for the star right now. I wonder where you are right now.
Travel so far, field and fountain, moor and Thank you so much. We appreciate it.